Q&A November. These are the questions that you guys asked, and I'm going to answer them right now. Well, a selection of them, not all of them, because that's a lot. That's really a lot. Alright, so there was one question from my patrons on patreon.com which I want to answer and which should be answered because they get priority. Awesome! Do you feel like releasing singles is finally the way to go these days? I don't think so, however I still believe in the classic scheme of releasing two singles, so one single, two single, and then an album. What I actually see is more album work these days in the studio. Complete albums that are being delivered to me and I need to mix them as a whole, instead of doing one song every single time. There's one cool thing about that, and that's that I can work in a batch. Then I can open several projects at the same time and mix them along the way. My console stays in the same setup and I only change small things, because most of the times, you know, the drums are recorded in the same way, so you only need to comply the drums to the song, for instance, or a different instrument. That way it takes up way less time and it's also a lot cheaper for the client. Doing an album is actually the way to go and not doing singles. But yeah, that's how I see the music industry. So the next are from the YouTube comment section, and the first ones are from the stem mastering video. I'm still not very healthy, by the way. Is it much better to separate snare and kick from the rest of the drum? Yeah, but you have to combine them somewhere in the process. During this stem mastering, it was actually really cool to have a drum group and to alter the drum kit as one instrument and not as separated instruments. VCV rec IDs. Is this really a stem mastering or a mixing? Yeah, there's a very thin line between stem mastering and mixing. What I always say is that, you know, mixing is also some creative influence from the mixing engineer, and with stem mastering there's much less creative influence in the mixing. And we actually use the production in stems in order to make the mastering a lot, well, not easier, but a lot more in-depth. We can alter a bit more, where sometimes you have a mix with a lot of stuff that's not really well and you cannot fix it with just a stereo file. To be honest, I'm always going a bit too far with stem mastering. I'm always want to run it through the console and have the summing on it, and yeah. Honey Bee, do you like stroopwafels and meisjes? Yes and yes. Only Dutch people will understand. Thomas Holak, here's the important question. Can I be a good engineer if I don't drink coffee? Yes, you can, but keep in mind that you have to stay hydrated. Very important. This is Dutch water, one of the best waters in the world. Matt Paul, even just setting up some GoPros will save you a lot of money and give you workable B-camera footage. Keep up the great work. No, GoPros don't give a very good image quality, if you ask me. Their compression, like the file compression, they use lossy compression and you cannot see any details. Also not very sharp image, because GoPros are made for, you know, outdoor heavy sport activities where you don't have time to focus, so everything is some sort of in focus. If I want to have a camera over here, like filming my console, I need a 4K camera, which is very sharp, so you can really detailed see what I'm actually doing, and I can also zoom in post, and then put out a 1080p production on YouTube. So, it will take some time. I already know which camera I want to have. I just need to save for it. Mastering should be a transparent and conservative process. If you run every trick in and out through converters multiple times in mixing and then even in mastering, you are destroying everything, because conversion is an approximation. And then you boost frequencies in the analog equalizer, introducing noise and distortion. This is not mastering, this is mixing, and you are doing it very wrong, destroying the quality of the original signal. Okay, I think I'll continue making videos then and not bother with audio anymore. I don't get the point. It sounded great when it came out of it. So why am I doing it wrong? Yoast B. Hey dude, what preamp do you use to get the signal out and back into the computer? It's not a preamp, it's actually a converter, and it's a Motu 16A over AVB. Above them all productions. I'm confused how you can add so much EQ without gain staging. How do you know what your EQ is doing versus what is just louder? It came from a lot of experience, of course, and I have to say that, you know, the Neumann has 24 decibels of headroom. You can add a lot of EQ and you can really boost things without getting overloading in your signal. And I also have to be honest, I'm always very low on my mix bus. I'm like minus 18 or something when I get started. So I have a lot of headroom already in the digital domain. RD Act. What's the benefit of mixing with a console and analog gear? I would find it inconvenient, but hell do I know. It's actually not that inconvenient, and you should actually try it out. If you're ever here in Arnhem, come mix a song on my console. Not everybody, because then... The thing is, you've everything accessible under your fingers directly, and that makes it so convenient. You do have to set up your session in the beginning, but you also have to set up your session for digital mixing. I mean, inserting plugins and stuff. So if you do that in the beginning and then just, you know, sit behind the console, way more convenient than you might think, but you have to experience that. All right, so moving on to the Sennheiser headphone video. Interesting to see a complete headphone noob from an audio professional community. Well, I'm not feeling that I'm part of a community. I'm building a community on the internet, but I'm not like actively posting on forums and stuff, because I actually hate most of the audio community. It's really interesting to test headphones as a audio engineer. I've been reading a lot about headphones, headphone amplifiers and stuff, and it's like, it's a whole different island. Really interesting for me, and I think, you know, my review video will still have a lot of things to think about in it. Ardayak. Again, I love how he doesn't test the headphones on his 32-bit hi-fi interface but uses them on his MacBook. I don't have a 32-bit hi-fi interface, I only have a 24-bit Motu interface. Which, according to a lot of guys, isn't hi-fi, but measure it and you will see how hi-fi it is. And then another one says, that's because I think he has enough experience to know he won't actually hear differences between standard 16-bits and 32-bits. With his human ears. No, there were actually two reasons why I was testing it on my MacBook. First one was because the MacBook was actually directly next to me. I could simply grab it and test it. And the second reason is the whole point of getting headphones for me was that I can mix from my MacBook. So if I could use the analog output on the MacBook, already help a lot. And I know that isn't very good quality, that output, but still, you should also take that into consideration. And what the difference is between the MacBook and a professional amplifier and if it's actually worth it. Bo Phil, why am I still seeing this even though I unsubscribed? Well, because you clicked on the video. Nicola Souser, I'm getting tired of Sandstorm. Can you test with Cairncraft 4000 next time? I cannot use my client's productions. Hello, Sino Ganichuski. So this is a remix of Neo from 2008. Do you guys have the rights from Universal and Island Records? Yes, and it wasn't actually that difficult. They simply asked. Nuno Ramos, is everything snake oil to you, dude? No. Armin, dumbest tester ever. Go play Pokemon. Nerdy trash. Well, you clicked on the video. I think you should play Pokemon, because I've never played Pokemon ever. I don't even know how it works. Toby Selby, are your thumbnails snake oil or do you get more views because of them? Yes, I get more views because of my thumbnails. That's how YouTube works. It's actually what YouTube recommends with their Creator Academy. They say make a thumbnail that make people click. So, let's do that. And with that being said, I want to end this Q&A. Sorry, I'm still having a bit of a cold. I will try to fix the audio in post so I won't sound as nasal as I'm actually doing. I probably will fail at that because I'm not that good of an audio engineer if I should listen to the comments from you guys. So thanks a lot for commenting and keep on the commenting work underneath this video and other videos. I will answer them maybe in the next video. If you want to make sure that I answer them, go check out Patreon and pledge more than $2 and you will get guaranteed answer to your comment in the next Q&A video. You can also support me by watching more videos or subscribe, liking this video, double disliking, and that's it. Thanks a lot for watching. See you guys again in the next video. Peace. Bye bye. Rock and roll. Bye bye. Bye bye.